Excitement as acting political leader Stephenson King arrived, but nothing near the hype that his opponent Allen Chastanet would receive when he walked in. The delegates erupted in a frenzy when Mr. Chastanet made his grand entrance. For many, it was a foregone conclusion that he had won even before the election process began. As new political leader, Mr. Chastanet has planned to conduct an audit of the constituency branches to determine their assets and how they should be allocated. And the new political leader does not see not having a seat in Parliament a problem. He cited Dr. Kenny Anthony and late George Charles as precedents.
We are going to be going on a strategic plan retreat, which will be the mid part of December, which will include the new executive as well as all the constituency branches. That would be about a three-day retreat, which we will be redefining the vision, the mission, and the values of the party, and coming out with a strategic plan by the end of the year. Once we have that in place, that is going to then start dictating some key things. There are two committees that we will be forming. One is a candidate selection committee, and then we're also going to be looking and reviewing the management report that was endorsed by the constituency branches today.
Mr. Chastanet also responded to reports that MP for Miku South, Alson James, would resign from his seat in order to pave the way for him to contest it, a notion which Mr. James himself categorically denies.
There is no truth, actually no truth in that statement. In fact, this is what he was just discussing with me and telling me this is all over town. But it's over town, but it's not in my constituency. I don't know anything about that. There has been no discussion about it. Nobody has approached me. I have not discussed it with anybody.
So there's no by-election to come?
Not at all. And there's not going to be any by-election.
Okay. What is your future? Are you planning to resign anytime soon?
Well, with me, I'm not a young man anymore. But there's a point I may have to give up. But that decision has not been taken.
Mr. Stephenson King, for his part, vowed to spend more time with his constituents now that he has been relieved of his duties as political leader. Then Mr. King related some of his own tribulations, incurring the sympathy of some, with one individual saying he was close to tears.
But the most trying time for me, really and truly, were the last 6 weeks in my life. I lost my mom in the process. And on Monday last week, my wife lost her job at the bank. So now, for me, I am accustomed with adversity. I know what it is to be down and out. And I know what it is to keep fighting until the end. The task ahead has just begun.
But Sunday's convention would not be short on drama. As Mr. King walked into the auditorium to hear the results, not all supporters took the final vote well. Some described those who rallied, or at least pretended to rally around Mr. King, as traitors. One Stephenson King reporter denouncing them as hypocrites. Others expressed the belief that the UWP would become a house divided against itself. MP for Castries Southeast Guy Joseph spoke on an incident yesterday where Mr. King apparently refused a handshake from his opponent after the results were announced.
I think I would still give him the benefit of the doubt at this time. Being defeated in a contest of this nature is not always easy to deal with. And it is human nature that when we are defeated, sometimes we behave in a certain way that upon reflection, we can say, well, you know, I could have done it differently. I believe it was the emotion of the moment that may have caused it. And I'm hoping for the sake of the party, for the sake of the supporters of the United Workers Party and St. Lucia, that this was just a moment's emotion and not a fixed position by the Honorable Stephenson King.
Later on, Mr. King made an apparent attempt to redeem himself, but it was quite evident that the relations with Mr. Chastanet were strained. Mr. Chastanet can be seen here warmly embracing the executive members, but when he got to Mr. King, It was reduced to a handshake. But despite all the remarks, new chairman of the political party Ezekiel Joseph would not be deterred. As far as he is concerned, the party has one mission, and that is to unseat the St. Lucia Labour Party. And he thinks this new executive is raring and ready to do so, and nothing will stand in its way. And the newly appointed chairman was forceful as he articulated the new path for the party. The party appointed two deputy leaders in Dr. Gail Rigobert and Leonard Mortute. The post of deputy chairman went to Andy Daniel and first vice chairperson went to Mary Polius. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.